First, I don't like the word sustainability. Sustainability assumes that we are in some good place and that all we have to do is maintain what we are doing, which is wrong. We are in crisis. We need to regenerate the soils. We need to regenerate forests and farms and natural areas. While there is no magic bullet that will fix it all, there is a magic pizza pie that has lots and lots and lots of slices. There's a cornucopia of solutions out there. And if we do all of those things, we fix those problems. Biodiversity is like a rich embroidered cloth. You can pick holes in it. You can take away a thread here and a thread there. It'll look increasingly ugly. But eventually, it'll simply snap because you have weakened it too much. Biodiversity is exactly the same thing, but at a level of complexity that is beyond imagining because it involves so many millions of species of things you can't even see in the soil, in the air, in the water. You can snuff out a species here, snuff out a species there, and it'll still work, but it'll become less and less resilient, more and more fragile. And eventually it flips, it dies. And this has happened before. In fact, it's the main reason why civilizations die, because it mishandled its environment. Today, our civilization encompasses the entire globe. So if this civilization dies, we're really in deep doo-doo. My name is Patrick Worms, and I'm a senior science policy advisor devoted to the study of trees in agricultural landscapes.
Okay, we're rolling.
I'm a preacher for a better way of managing landscapes. Healthy soils are the difference between a living planet and the moon, right? Without healthy soils, you're stuffed. Land degradation is a global issue. 97% and more of the land surface of this planet has already been damaged by humans. The agricultural sector is by far the most important industrial sector for managing this planet. When you till the soil, you damage the biodiversity of the soil. It is alive. It's filled with all sorts of little things. Changing agricultural practices to reduce emissions from agriculture is not only possible, it's usually cheap. You can probably drive those emissions right down to zero without stopping the production of what you want. It's got enormous potential. And by happy coincidence, you're not just solving the carbon crisis, you're also solving the biodiversity crisis. That means that our farms need trees in them, they need animals in them, they need shrubs in them, they need many different plants cooperating in them. Trees provide distributed shade, and that's especially important in hot summer months because crops will stop growing in the hottest hours of the day to protect their water supply. Trees reduce wind speeds, which means that your crops grow better. And trees provide protection against pest and disease. Many trees on top of that fix nitrogen. So what rains down onto your field through those leaves is nitrogen, so the main component of fertilizer. Trees attract birds, and birds bring in their own fertility through their poop, and they eat insects, and so suddenly you have the beginnings of a functioning ecosystem again. Then add animals and manage them well. We always hear that there's too much livestock in the world and it's responsible for a lot of land degradation. That's not quite accurate. What's responsible for the land degradation is the mismanagement of livestock. You move the animals in and you say, you have to eat everything. And with your hooves, you are going to trample the weeds that are toxic underground. You are pooing and you're adding a lot of fertility to that land. Then I'm going to take these animals off and let that land rest. And you are going to have an explosion of life there. So suddenly, your animals have become a part of the solution and have regenerated the soil. All that explosion of life that you see above the ground also means an explosion of life below the ground. The roots going deep into the soil are made of carbon. So you're putting carbon into the soil. By applying these agroecological interventions, you've improved the functioning of the landscape. You've created new sources of nutrition and revenue. Farmers who want to move in the direction of agroecology or agroforestry need one thing above all: quality advice on what to do and how to do it. And in an environment in which agricultural extension agents cannot give that advice, the phone can become the difference between bad farming and good farming. Imagine a phone with an app. That app knows what the local biome would look like if there was no human interaction. It knows what plants and what animals and what trees are native to the area. It knows the values of the different crops, both today and also on the future markets. It can give you advice on how to deal with disease, with pruning, with a combination of animals and crops, etc. It does so in your own native language, and it does so on an easy interface that doesn't require you to be a scientist. That is the promise of digital technology in farming. The right kind of forest is essential to the future of this planet. The wrong kind of forest is large-scale, monospecies plantations. The sooner we can transform them into something better, the better off the planet and humanity will be. There is always an optimal solution. Let nature inspire us, because nature has found solutions through trial and error of many hundreds of millions of years. Soil is dynamic. You can degrade it, but you can also restore it. And if you do it well, you can restore it with amazing speed.